Got him. He's done. You got him good. You smoked him.
I left Oklahoma driving in a Pontiac, just about to lose my mind.
Good shot, good shot.
I was going to Arizona, maybe on to California, where the people all live so fine. My baby said I was crazy. My mama called me lazy.
2022,
I was going to show them all this time. Cause you know I ain't no fool.
It's a
I don't need no more schooling. I was born to just walk the line.
Smoked him.
Living on Tulsa time.
This looks like a shit already.
Living on Tulsa time. Well, you know I've been through it. When I set my watch back to it. Living on Tulsa time.
All right, back at it again with another episode of Hooked on Huntin. Forgot the name of our podcast for a second. Well, did you guys have a good weekend?
I did. Didn't get out, but it was still a good week.
Good weekend?
Yeah, it's all right. Didn't get out. It's
a
good weekend.
So
yeah,
we're slapping
over
here.
Yeah, they are. Well, I made it out, and I had the best shed hunt of my year so far.
Probably for a long time.
I found 6 sheds. That was my best so far this year.
Nothing too crazy, right?
No, I found a couple forked horns. I found one forked horn. I found a 3-point, another 3-point. And I found a 4-point, and I found a 5-point set. anyways, where's that? Oh. So I guess I'll start off by showing this guy off. Big ol' 4-point. This was biggest blacktail shed I've ever picked up. Hand that to you there. It looks like it's this year's brown, but
he says white.
Yeah, it was last year's shed actually. It was just it's in crazy good condition how I found it.
Yeah.
Some heavy sacks.
That's a cool color.
Yeah, so I picked up this little forked horn. It's in there somewhere. I'm not even
actually.
Yeah, no, I'm not grabbing that. I picked up a little forked horn. It was like that big. You know. And I was like, all right, we're on the board, but I felt like it was just going to be a really long day. You know, I'm going to have to work hard to find some big sheds. And then me and my buddy that I went in there with, we came across this meadow. That's how I ended up picking up a little forked horn. And then he picked up a forked horn too. And then we ended up splitting up once we got out on top of this. So we're on like a hillside in this meadow. It's like, it's hard to explain, but it goes around the hillside, and then once you get up on top, it's still the same meadow, I guess, but it's just a different. But we were wrapping around the side after we picked up those forked horns, and I just got up on top, and Lucas he kept going around, and then came from the bottom, and I got into like a little sliver of timber that was like in the middle of the big meadow, I guess, and I seen this guy laying there. I was like, oh my gosh. I was just freaking out. This is my biggest shed.
Right.
And then right after, you know, I get all some pictures and I pick up video and everything, Lucas calls me. He's like, dude, I just found the biggest shed I've ever found in my life. And I was like, oh, me too. And we got to talking about it on the phone. I was like, well, we should probably meet up because I bet you we got the set. So like, yeah, this one, it looks like it just dropped about a week ago. I was like, oh, never mind. Because this shed I picked up, it wasn't this year's brown. It was last year's. And so I told him that. And I asked him what side he had. And he said left. And I told him I had the left side too. And we figured we'd meet up anyways, kind of show each other what we got. And then we're going to go back out and start matching them up. And all this happened within about 15 minutes of finding both our sheds, meeting up. And then we decided we're gonna go back to where we came from and start gridding hard, matching them up. On my way in back into the sliver of timber, I found a giant. So I found that guy, big old 5-point. I'd guess it's like a 70 to 75 inch single. Big old heavy sucker. That's last year's shed too.
Yeah, that's great.
And so, you know, after we split up, I found it. I was freaking out. So I ended up yelling at Lucas, telling him to come back up. And then we had another buddy with us, and he came back over to check it out. And I didn't even touch it until they got up there. And once they got up there, we picked it up and we're looking at it, just freaking out. I mean, yeah. And anyways, we ended up just doing what we planned on doing, just going back to our spots and gridding hard for, you know, the other side of that guy. And then I knew I had to match this guy up one way or another. And about an hour and a half later, I found the other side. Big old giant 5x5 set.
Like this guy. How far apart were they?
About 250 yards. Something like that. I found this guy, like I said, in that little sliver of old growth. And then I found this guy. No, mind you, well, no, I'm not lying, but I found this in a little sliver of old growth with like some pine trees mixed in it. And somehow it kept its color really good. And it didn't get chewed on at all. And then I found this guy in nothing but pure old growth. So you can tell the color difference. Just green, big old gnarly sucker. Yeah. So I want to say it's about 250 yards apart. And so that was the highlight of my trip, was those three behemoths. I thought it was kind of cool. You know, I found my biggest shed, but this being my biggest shed, it only lasted for about 15 minutes before I beat it, found that set. But yeah, since I did find this set, we got the idea of just talking about our biggest sheds, so let's hear your side of the...
My pair.
Yeah.
Picked up these in June 2023, and I don't know, it's kind of a funny story. I was on a little hike and with my uncle, who didn't really know anything about deer and whatever else, and I picked up the biggest blacktail sheds I'd ever seen. I still haven't seen anything that looks like this from this area, but I pulled them. I knew they were big as I was walking down to it, and then pulled them out of the bushes. They were laying right on top of each other like that. And
yeah, the pickup video is insane.
Yeah,
it's on the YouTube too.
And
so
I didn't see all the extras and stuff. I saw these two and then the triple off the back there, and I'm like, oh, that's gonna be my biggest shed. And then I pull them out and they just get crazy. It's got the broken off dropper and big hook on the one side.
Jeez. Crown
that
Jesus.
Side's got a crown, and that front fork on this one just,
you can't make those up.
I don't know the math on this one.
For the area
crazy.
You found those in, that just makes it even more insane.
Yeah, I got them scored last weekend, and they scored 161 and 7/8. And for this kind of blacktail, that's pretty crazy.
Yeah. That's considered a coastal blacktail, isn't it? Yeah. That, for a coastal blacktail, that is...
Yeah.
That's insane. And when you got them scored, what kind of category? Like, what were the specifics that you got put in? Like, what kind of blacktail? And like, was it like a youth?
It was
thing,
no. There was, so for youth, they don't. For sheds, they don't do a youth.
Yeah, it's just sheds.
So, yeah, it was Western blacktail. It was official Boone and Crockett scored. They estimated the width at 18. That's where the 161 comes from. But I don't know, I was pretty stoked. That put me at 6 and 7 for the state record book. So
just for sheds.
It's pretty crazy, but, yeah.
Yeah.
And then
wow. That is
crazy.
That is big blacktail buck.
Yes. Yeah. I guess for reference, I got a 16-ounce can
that fits in that
front fork.
Hold it up again, kind of going
both. Yeah, let's get them both up here.
Oh my gosh.
I'm probably
so not. This one, track, but it's like from where I'm looking at it, that one's like a bigger framed deer.
Oh yeah, he goes like
that one just has
up
so
here
many inches on it. It's yeah, like,
and the mass carries up through all the points.
Dude, if this guy had all the kickers that guy did, you both would lock your minds.
You're sitting close to it. I haven't got it scored yet, but I'm gonna assume that guy's somewhere in the 150s. He's gotta be a 150s buck.
He's big.
Dude, there you go.
But with these, I know another guy that kicked up a shed that looks pretty similar to this one. It's got the crown off the back and the big middle that comes up through there, but it's not the same bug. He's got different bases and everything.
Same area.
Wow. So it's a genetic thing, so hopefully there's a couple more of these running around and we'll dig another one up. But I'm pretty stoked with them. I don't think I'll ever find something like this again. I might find, you know, bigger typicals or just bigger framed bucks, but as far as character and mass and everything goes, yes, I think this is it for me. And
you can't talk bad about these sheds. So it's like, I don't know how long my arm is, but that darn near goes all the way out to my hand.
Right.
Yeah, 12 inch can right there.
That's not 12 inches, John.
I mean, 12 ounces. My bad. I was trying to say.
I got the 16 ounce can. The front fork slides right in there. But
oh, yeah. Wow.
I don't know. For reference.
Look at that. Oh, yeah. Dude. Yeah. All right, John. Let's hear you. First of all, you better grab it, but let's hear you talk about your biggest shed.
It's not really my biggest shed, it's just a pretty cool shed.
A big shed.
Which one? What are we gonna go with again? What, this thing here?
You can talk about your four. Well, have we talked about your four? I don't know.
Yeah, we talked about the weird tree, the 4 points I found in a row. I think we already talked about this elk shed, though. I was gonna grab a different one here.
Okay.
I'm going to go with this first elk shed I've ever found. That was, 4 years ago, I think it was. I was riding in the pickup, and we were going up this road, and happened to look on the bank, and all I seen was just that much. Like 10, 20 yards up the bank. I finally got my dad to stop. I ran back there. I thought it was a big old deer shed or something. I ended up grabbing it when I pulled it out of the ground. It was just this big old spike bull elk shed.
That's a big spike, too.
Yeah.
Could you imagine, like, you're out in the...
Something with that?
Yeah, just out in the timber, dude. You just pick this sucker up, bear, cougar comes out of nowhere, dude. This is probably my go-to weapon.
Just made it.
Big old meat cleaver, dude.
Self-defense. Dude, you can, little knobs
you can,
on the
you
top.
You can gore it like a caveman, or you could just swing at that sucker right in the jaw.
Yep.
That thing.
Use that big knob right good there.
Do that.
Hit the dome or the temple.
Those are lethal.
Here, you want to find out? Let's go.
I'm okay. Yeah.
But these things, it's like, I've never been there before. Well, I've been there. I just wasn't really shedding. And I think I actually walked by them. I don't know. It was the year that they dropped, and I walked through there. I don't know if they were there or not, but there was snow on the ground and whatever else. So I didn't see them. But went back and
it's insane.
They were in the weirdest spot. It was like in a little clear cut, and I'd never expect to find sheds like this there, like a buck of this caliber, where they were.
Didn't one of your family, I don't remember who, but I think I remember, one of your family members, didn't he tell you, I think, about
he saw
him seeing some sort of insane
yeah
buck, and that's gotta be it.
Could have been it.
Could have been.
But
that's gotta be
like
it.
Like I said, he's genetic. Wow. So. The other shed was found about a mile apart, the one that I said looks like this.
Yeah, the cool part about when I found these, though, when I found the first side, I was up on this knob, working my way back into the sliver, old growth, that guy I picked up out of. He was just laying like this, and I'm standing up the hill, and I see just a stick sticking up, and it looked like a big tine. And I was like, oh, that's gotta be a shed. I pull my binos up, I'm looking at the stick, and I was like, dang it. But I look behind the stick, like four and a half, maybe 5 yards, and I can see this tine sticking up, that tine sticking up, and either, yeah, it was this tine sticking up, and I was like, okay, that's sweet, there's a shed down there. I remember yelling, shed horn for Lucas, and I'm thinking it's actually just a small buck, you know, just a set on top of each other, and I get up to about 20 yards away from it, and I can see all the tines I've seen all connect into one main beam, and I was like, oh my goodness, and yeah, and so that's when I started yelling. I had Aaron run over, Lucas come up, and we did a pickup video, and it was just insane. I don't know really how to describe it, but.
And we'll put like the ATLs and stuff on here.
Oh yeah, you'll see it for sure. And then on the YouTube, you'll definitely see the pickup videos. Mm-hmm. And that wasn't even it. We ended up overall, out of us three up there, we found 13 sheds. I found 6 of them, and this 4-point that I picked up, I don't really know how to, like, what's a good reference for telling you how big it is, but this is big.
It's
this
big.
Is a big 4-point.
It's big.
Lucas picked up a big 4-point too. I told you that, you know, he said he found his biggest shed. This 4-point, because they're both left sides, you could fit this inside of the 4-point he picked up, so. Even though it's a big shed, there's
some big
bigger boys up there. And what I thought was crazy is how there's all these big bucks in one, you know, it's not a little area, but for the area we only searched, how there's that many big bucks in that little area. It's insane.
That's crazy. How I found these, like I said, they were out in the clear cut, so there's flowers and sticks and everything.
Yeah, I remember in the pit.
I was standing on a rock or a stump or something, I can't remember, and I'm like, oh, there's a little flower down there, because I just saw that base sticking up. And then I pulled up my binos, and I saw the eye guard, and I'm like, oh, that's a shed, but his bases really aren't that big. So
they're pretty,
like,
though. Pretty cool.
I was like, that's not a big shed, I'll be right back. I told my uncle when I pulled this thing out of the dirt. But
I think
it's cool how you spot them like this. This was the first buck I've...
We got tons going everywhere. Here, grab that, John.
Okay.
Can you, like, prop these up and make them stand?
I don't know.
Nah. Can you do this with that one?
No. No, they're too. But you can't lay them down and have them sit like that. They just fall over. That one does. Like, how I found them was with the bases sticking up in the air like that.
Yeah, no.
Both of them. And it was cool because I saw this one, and then I walked up to it, and I saw that one's base kind of come across with just the front fork, and that's all I could see. Because it was June, and the vegetation was all growed up, and he was in, like, a thing of flowers. It was the coolest little scenario.
It kind of, the way you found them, the way they were laying in the video,
it's pretty cool.
I wonder what that buck was doing.
Right, I think he jumped over a log and they landed like that.
I feel like the deer.
Sure, that down.
Anyway, what were you saying? Hold on.
Just with the way the trail went across there, I think he jumped over a log and when he jumped over.
Yeah, normally when you find a set and they're right by, like, right on top of each other, the deer is almost, it's like stationary, I feel like. I don't think the deer was really moving around.
Right.
So that's what kind of makes me think is, like, how they got there like that. Was the deer, you think he could have been bedded down at all? Did it look
not
like he was
moving? Maybe.
No. Yeah, no, he had to have been moving.
Yeah, and with as heavy as these, they're going to land and fall out.
Yeah,
but.
These probably dropped first weekend of January.
Right.
Maybe before that, you never know. I've always wondered if the big bucks like these, if they even drop, you know, in like December time or whatever.
Yeah.
I've always wondered when the earliest they drop. I don't know.
Hopefully, this year's just getting started too. I mean, I know I found these last year, but we're still hitting the hills for this year. I've only gone out twice. And I found 7 sheds this year.
I got to show, where's the logo shed? Right
over there, I
think. You guys keep talking to me.
You know, it's a bad deal when we gotta dig through sheds to find a certain one. There's a lot of sheds here.
I think that's it right there.
Trying not to make a lot of noise.
Oh, you're good.
Alright. So, I think I said in the last episode, this was my biggest shed before any of this happened. This was my biggest shed. Look at that. And that's the big 4-point that I picked up yesterday.
Yeah.
And it's like insane, the difference. So hold that one. And then you got this guy that I found like 15 minutes after. It's the same deal. It just fits inside of it.
Yeah.
I get all three of them lined up.
Oh, it's fine. But it's just these bucks. I don't know. That's the reason you shed not right there.
Yeah.
That's the reason you go hike 10 plus miles in one day. And, you know.
And being blacktail too. Like, I mean, I'm not feeding on male deer guys, but that's like your average male deer shed right there. Well, it's big, let's be honest.
This is probably your average mule deer shed, maybe.
I'd say, yeah, that's close.
I don't know.
If you found these...
No, you got mule deer started, so I don't know.
You'd still be pretty stoked.
Yeah. I feel like they just pick up more quality sheds, maybe because we're used to blacktail sheds, of course.
Yeah.
But just more quality sheds because the way that they bachelor up. But then you find a buck like this, and it can be once in a lifetime for some people.
Gee, that's exactly how it is for
both
of
us.
I mean... I'm sure
it's
going to
take a long time if we ever beat these.
But I'm sure, you know, it's a high possibility it's good. It just all has to do with time.
Mm-hmm.
You got to have the time for it.
Yeah,
time.
And you're going to go out for sure, and you'll put on all these miles, and sometimes you won't even find it.
Mm-hmm.
But it makes it worth it when you go out and you hit a bone zone.
I was thinking about maybe presenting the idea to you guys about having a goal for every month that we should hold each other accountable to.
It's hard to hold accountable when it comes to shed hunting because
Last year I wanted to find a shed a month.
We don't have as much time as
we'd
normally have, you know, like
last
year.
What
is it?
I was going to talk about my big green set.
Start talking about last night, I'll find that one.
It was kind of cool. I grew up in this area. It was close to one of my houses that I lived in, and I knew that there was big bucks that would come through there. And I don't know. I just went back because I moved out of that house, and I went back to it now that I'm in a shed hunting. And my goal today was to find a big green shed. And finally, I did. I mean, they're not green anymore.
I think we're being kind of loud.
Yeah, you're fine. Oh, you're fine. It doesn't matter. We'll throw pictures up there.
I like that, though. The fact that we can find it.
That, actually, give me that. This came from the same spot.
It's got a nice little kicker on it.
And then another one that came from the same spot. I found like 6 sheds right here. It's cool, because it was a house that I used to live at. Found my first shed there, and I found several others there. There's a big, heavy 3. I don't know, we got so many sheds.
I love this.
Yeah, that's my second shed I've ever found. He's a big... He's a
set?
He, like, goes forward. He goes forward like this one. There's some genetic thing right in there.
Oh, that's not the set.
I brought the set in last week, so they should be on this set.
Yeah,
but it's just, it's cool to see the genetics. I mean, they look pretty similar. I don't know, I had in my mind that I wanted a big green set, and I found one this day.
Yeah, finding it in the shed pile is almost just as hard as finding it out in the woods.
Right.
Yeah.
I found it on an old skid road, something had jumped off the bank, and they landed, I don't know, a few feet from each other.
When you did find them though, in the video, it looked like one of them was like almost newer than the other one.
Right.
One got over
yeah, even long. Still.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't know. It's the same buck. I didn't even see one side, but in the video I kind of played it off as if I did. But I didn't see it till.
That's
I
was not
recording.
The first time that's happened.
Yeah, no, I've done it a lot. And I've been recording pickup.
This guy's taking pictures of a shed. You didn't even realize that in the same picture the other side was laying like 5 feet apart.
Yeah, I've been in the middle of pickup videos and lost my mind because I saw the other side and had to redo it. I get excited over these things.
Oh yeah.
But that was a cool little set. That one definitely got me started.
Yeah, I know. And I remember it because we didn't have all these sheds.
No, this was one of the bigger sets we had.
We thought that was a toad.
Yeah.
I mean, it's not a small bug, but yeah.
But compared to that one.
We're just, we've got new spots and we've put on more miles and we both have driver's licenses now. Just little fresh stuff like that that helps a lot.
One thing I've noticed is when you're out shed hunting, I've noticed that the deer, they don't like wind.
Right.
If you can, if you're on a, in some timber or on a hillside that's just windy, I mean, you got wind falls on the ground, you might find some sheds just because, you know, a coyote or something packed it around, or the deer just happened to be there when it lost a shed. But you gotta, if you're not finding any, you gotta, you know, kind of start thinking about the elements, about wind, you know, where the water's at. I mean, but the wind is just one of the biggest factors because the deer just don't like it. So you gotta relocate, you know, get into a draw or something that's blocking the wind. And that's where I notice I start to get into more sign. Mm-hmm. You know, not every time I'm gonna find a shed, but the sign is there. That's just one of the big factors on it.
Not only that, you're gonna find them in some terrible places, like brushy and all get out.
Just like that oak shed.
Yeah, almost never found that thing.
And it's not like the places they shed, one's more likely than the other. It's just where they spend most time. Like people say, south-facing slopes, it's not that the gravitational pull's higher over there and the sheds just tend to fall off. It's just where the deer are spending more time.
Right.
And that's...
They got a routine.
You want to find bedding areas and travel between bedding and feed.
Water.
Everything like that.
Yep. I got to ask this. Has any of y'all ever found one in a creek, like in the water?
Yeah. Not yet.
I kind of want to find one like that. I think it'd pretty sweet.
Have I? I found one, so like the creek runs through, you know, and you got some steep banks where the deer either jump across the creek or go down and up.
Yeah.
I had one shed just, I seen its base sticking up on one of the little creek banks where you knew the deer lost it jumping across there.
Right. Yeah.
But I hadn't found one in the water.
I think that'd be sweet.
I've seen people do it.
Yeah.
Or elk sheds.
Yeah. Especially elk sheds. I've seen people pull elk sheds out of log jams and beaver dams.
Right.
Just
I always look for that big washouts. Like if you're up in the mountains against rocks or whatever, I always try to walk the washouts just in case something was sucked in with it.
That would be
you
cool.
You know, a dead deer. Or like you find a dead head or a shed. I haven't yet, but I was probably a pretty good possibility of it.
Mm-hmm.
I've got a spot I want to hit that. I don't know. I hope I find something, but it's just got one of those big washouts through the middle. I want to go through and walk the whole thing, just see if there's something there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, shoot. Same side. Well, no, that's what I'm talking about. I don't remember which side it was, but one of them is the one I found on that creek bank. And then, like, 20 yards away from it, I found another side off of the same buck. I never could find the other two sides, but... Yeah, so that, I want to say it was that one that was on the creek bank.
Oh, makes sense.
Yeah.
That's a cool buck. We used to think that this was a monster, too.
Yeah, I remember I tried trading these two for the weird four.
Right?
Yeah. Yeah, I wanted that shed so bad.
It's flat.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's a cool buck.
I mean, it's got to be the same buck.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, they got the same
eye guard on my side. Showing the bagger. Mm-hmm. It's all bladed out.
Yeah,
that might be flat. Yeah, same with that one there.
Now I want to go shed hunting.
Right.
I want to go.
Yeah, after that hike you did yesterday, I called the guy today to see if I could get permission to shed on his property.
Mm-hmm.
So, I mean, after seeing what you were picking up, I'm like, I gotta go shed hunting.
Yeah,
so.
Yeah, that's how it was for me after John picked up all those. Yeah.
And that's what we're here with. Like, encourage you guys to do. Just get out there.
Get off your phone. Yep. Put your book down.
Quit watching us. Go pick up somewhere.
Yeah.
Or you don't watch us. I'm sure your friends.
I was going to say, don't stop watching us. Just show everybody what you're doing.